Credits. I am Lieutenant Dr. Ritu Dhanoa. The topic of my presentation is threats to national security. Now, as we all know that food, clothes, shelter, they all are essentials of our life, or we can say they are the rights that a citizen should have. Similarly, the safety and the security, they can also be considered as the essentials, or we can say the rights of the citizens. Now, who is responsible for giving us the security or the safety to the citizens? Who has this responsibility? It is the responsibility of the government of the country to make its citizens feel secure. No doubt that our country is growing at a very good pace, but still there are internal and external threats which are haunting our nation. So we need national security. National security is required to maintain the survival of the state through the use of economic power, diplomacy, power projection, and political power, so as to promote a peaceful global environment for the citizens. Now, cadets, this slide shows the various definitions of national security. You can go through any one definition. Like, national security is the security of the country within its borders. It means maintenance of peace, law, order, and upholding the sovereignty of the country within its territory. But it's very important for you to understand the last point, that is, the national security is a combination of external security and internal security. This external security is the responsibility of the armed forces. Like, if there are any cross-border disputes, it becomes the responsibility of the armed forces to handle it. Whereas the internal security, or the security of the citizens within the national boundaries of the country, it is generally the responsibility of the police, which may sometimes be supported by the central armed forces in case of emergencies or in case of need. Now, this slide shows that what provisions are being made in our country for the national security of our citizens. For the internal security of the country, the Minister of Home Affairs or the Minister of Internal Affairs is responsible. He is responsible for the maintenance of internal security and domestic policy. And it is for your knowledge that our current Minister of Home Affairs is Shri Amit Shah. And for the external security of our country, it is the responsibility of the Ministry of Defence. And our current minister is Shri Rajnath Singh. He is a Minister of Defence. Now, in India, we also have a National Security Council, which is also known as Rashtriya Suraksha Parishad. Now, what is this National Security Council? National Security Council is a government agency which basically works and frame guidelines with regards to the security of the citizens of the country, both domestic as well as national security. Now, this NSC was formed by our former Prime Minister of India, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, in the year 1998. Now, this council consists of various members. The senior most is the National Security Advisor, and with him there are certain cabinet members. Now, in the fourth point, I have given the members of this council. First is the National Security Advisor. Second is the Deputy National Security Advisor. Then we have the Ministers of Defense, both External Affairs and Internal Affairs. Then we have the Finance Minister. And then we have the Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog. They all are the members of this council. And PM, the Prime Minister of the country, generally chairs the meeting of NSC. The national security threats can be classified into two, that is, the internal threats and the external threats. They have been explained in the next slides. Now, what are the internal security threats to our citizens? Now, if we see, we all know that poverty, unemployment, and corruption in our country are the major threats to the citizens. Apart from these, There are another internal threats to our citizens, such as the inequality. There is a huge difference between the rich and the poor. The Naxalites, which are mainly found in the areas of West Bengal, Jharkhand, Orisha, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. Then drug trafficking, arms smuggling. Then we also lag behind the technology and the infrastructure. We are far behind in the technology, in the field of technology and infrastructure as compared to the developed nations. Then the increase of cyber threats, that has also become an internal threat to our citizens. Then the unreformed criminal justice system, lack of balanced regional development, criminalization of politics, total inflation in our country, especially in the time of COVID, environment degradation, and continuous religious wars and caste crimes. They all are internal threats to our citizens. The second type of threat are the external security threats, or we can say the cross-border threats, which continuously are coming from various countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh, China, also sometimes from Myanmar, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, etc. We all know about the LSE dispute going between India and China. This is an example of external security threat. We all know about the jihadi terrorism in JNK. That is also an external security threat. Then there is continuous cross-border terrorism attacks by the Pakistanis. The relationship of India with Bangladesh, Myanmar, Nepal, Bhutan are also not very good. They are generally because of the illegal migration, the smuggling, fake money transfers, illegal drug trades by both the countries. So these all are covered under external security threats. This slide shows the attributes or the dimensions or the elements which are necessary to maintain the national security in our country. Now refer to these few points, such as secure the territorial integrity and protect the internal sovereignty, maintenance of domestic peace, law and order, equality to all, absence of fear in the minds of citizens, socio-political stability, territorial integrity, economic solidarity, ecological balance, cultural cohesiveness, moral spiritual consensus, peace and harmony. If all these things are followed by the citizens of our country, they surely are going to contribute towards the security of our country. Now, in our country, we also have a national security doctrine. Now, what is this doctrine? This doctrine is a document. It is a guide for the government of the country so that it can take various decisions on security matters. Security matters, both strategic and operational. That means it is a guide for the government that how it has to react on the various security problems. Agar kisi bhi tarah ki koi security problem aa jati hai, jaise ki militancy, insurgency, koi territorial attack hai, jaise abhi LSE dispute chal raha hai between India and China. So what steps a country can take to solve such problems, this doctrine helps the government of the country. Now, ये जो doctrine होता है वो mainly कौन से elements को cover करता है? That has been given in the last point कि in case अगर कोई political grievance है, कोई socio-economic grievance है, some corruption matters, any political issues, or what can we do to strengthen our police and security forces, or what can we do to develop our intelligence agencies, or what can we do to strengthen our border management and cyber security. The government of the country can take the help of this doctrine and find out the solutions to the problems or the crisis. Now, what steps you as citizens of the country can do to maintain peace in our country? This obviously is going to contribute towards the national security of the country. Agar hamari country mein peace rahega, law and order rahega, to security issues jo hain wo control mein rahenge. So as a citizen, you must always follow the law and order. You must be patriotic, you must be vigilant, And in case if need arises, you must be ready to provide any information to the security agencies. Jai Hind cadets, take very good care of yourself. Stay home, stay safe.